r/AskReddit by Reddit and chill. People who use incognito mode on your web browser for reasons other than porn. What are those reasons? Really ducking weird question that I'm too embarrassed to have on my search history. Or you don't want ad recommended or associated with your user profiles. Usually. To ask a stupid question I should know the answer to at my age. But don't want anyone to know I had to Google it to find out. How to use tie shoes that only have two shoelaces. Bypass having to subscribe to read articles. An extension for articles that's similar to this. Like when they block something with a huge subscribe button you can't close. You can use behind the overlay. It doesn't work in too many situations. But it's really nice when it does. I want to see results of things without previous searches impacting my search. And I want to Google something without getting ads for it later. Testing HTML at work. This. But for all aspects of a website. As it ensures any JS, CSS, passwords, cookies aren't cached and you can get a fresh copy of the website without having to clear your history. Edit. Clarity. Being signed into multiple email accounts. Checking personal email at work without the machine saving the credentials. As a developer. To see an uncached website after I published a change. Yeah, I use incognito mode a lot for this reason too. Cookies can really duck up a website. I use incognito on my phone because I like the dark outlines better than the white. You know Google already has a dark mode, right? Years of an abusive relationship with a parent who didn't trust me for some reason and would constantly invade my privacy. So I wouldn't have much time to be clearing my browser. I'm technically an adult now. And although we are much closer, I still do it. Habit. I had a family member who was able to check the house's Wi-Fi history and would bring up whatever I was looking at. Took me a while to realize they were doing this and it still deeply bothers me. Got so scared of searching anything on the Wi-Fi because my privacy was always invaded, so I used my phone's data. But still not sure if my family can see my data history. Anyways, wow, I relate to this. It is awful. YouTube videos I wanna watch but don't wanna get recommendations from. Researching anal fissures to see what I need to do to get them treated. I don't want all my targeted advertisements to be about anusol. When checking out travel resort hotel prices. You will be surprised to see the difference between normal and incognito mode prices. Edit. I watched a YouTube documentary where they were booking travel online using normal browsing and private. In case of private browsing, they were getting better prices. Some sites use dynamic pricing based on your location and browser history. So using private browsing may give you better prices. Wellinger.com link. Just to test, I just searched Costa Rica all inclusive in both modes. Here is the result. Incognito is more expensive, which proves prices can change based on your browser mode. So try both before buying anything. My favorite one was when I was in Atlantic City and looking up hotel prices while you were in that hotel would show $25 a night. But turn on a VPN and check from anywhere else and now the price becomes $80 a night. To check the spelling of embarrassingly simple words. Yeah. That's embarrassing. Sometimes you just don't want anyone to find out the medically relevant things you're looking up. I want my doc ambulance driver to look up every medical question they can think of. To look up products I'm interested in without getting 1001 ads for said items over the next 2 weeks. They still have your IP and use it for personalization. DuckDuckGo is your best bet. Nice try, FBI. Not today. CIA. When I want to watch a YouTube video without it ducking up my recommendations. Like seriously. Watching something related to video games shouldn't automatically signal to the algorithm that I have even a passing interest in right wing. SJW gets destroyed. Defenestrated. Mutilated. And burnt beyond recognition with facts and logic type shit. Duck out of here with that. You watch one video about spraying feet with solid vinegar. And it just won't go away. I have my work laptop logged into my Google account, so anything that may not be work safe that I look at home. I use incognito mode so the search history won't show up when you look at the other device's history in Chrome. Incognito mode only keeps you logged in for that incognito session. Close the window and those cookies are deleted. So if I'm signing into one of my accounts on someone else's computer, I use incognito so I don't have to remember to sign out. Same thing with other people using mine. Since it's separate from your main browser stuff, it's great when using different alternate accounts on one PC. No logging out of my main account. Just open an incognito window and sign in. It is a godsend for web development QA too. Being able to have what is essentially a fresh copy of a browser, no cookies, no data or whatever, without having to go through any hassle is amazing. Makes debugging way easier. Also for weird questions and for things I don't advertisers trying to target me for, normally when my mom wants me to go on some couponer sites. Same thing with watching YouTube videos without them affecting my recommended tab. To be real, I peruse more porn outside of incognito than I do in incognito. Too much hassle to open another window after the first. And you can always just get an extension to auto-delete search history if you really care that much. I use it for all of my alts. This is my porn alt. But that's not fully relevant. I once got subcontracted to do some work for a cult. Didn't know who the client was until I got on location. I used incognito later that day to research the cult. I know it's just security theater but still. Does your username work? Buying Christmas gifts. Also, I buy a lot of stuff for work and don't want it affecting my recommendations. When I use other people's devices, I use incognito mode. I never connect my devices to other people's Wi-Fi. Work. Don't want to accidentally buy personal stuff on the work Amazon. Also, don't want to see adverts for my work stuff on every website I go to. Buy the Terra solutions now. Shit I have to research for writing. Like how much force shattering a kneecap would require. Or would a man be entirely crippled from that knee after this ordeal? Should the man have had died after this painful trauma? How many times a day a man can wank? Yes. Yes. You what? I write in my spare time. And I Google a lot of things I don't want in my search history. Most recently, I was writing a childbirth scene and I used incognito mode because I didn't want anyone who uses my computer to start rumors about me being pregnant. I use it when I want to look up lyrics to songs that I'm too embarrassed to admit that I like. I'll usually look up the lyrics. Binge the song full blast when I'm driving and sing my heart out, while making sure to lower the volume at red lights. And then once it's out of my system I'm able to go back to being a pretentious music snob. I don't like being followed. Got sick of going to commercial or newspaper website and seeing the advert containers trying to sell me something from a website I'd visited earlier or even the day before. News sites are trying to block viewers in incognito mode now. But if you go to regular mode, then they put you on a guest subscription that expired after 1 to 3 article views. There are simple ways around most newspaper paywalls of demand. For the rest, somewhat less simple ones that take maybe 5 minutes to set up. Booking flights. Mainly just porn. Sometimes I look up weight loss tips and things like that. Don't want people to know how self-conscious I really am, lol. Out of habit. Dumbest questions that most people should know. Like for some reason my brain shuts off when I need to know something simple like 6×3. It's 42 stupid. I don't do it but I will in the future. Getting a gift for your so online and not wanting evidence that you were getting them one or what it is. Airplane tickets. Heard they change prices based on whether or not you've searched for them before. Browsing fanfic on a 03. I skim tags desk while scrolling down. Usually know to stop and download when the title is gray instead of blue. Meaning it's been clicked before. Sometimes I'm not sure if I want to read a new one or not. So I'll use incognito to keep the link unclicked to decide without throwing me off later if I don't like it. To see if some mod removed one of my comments. You can see it. But no one else can. Cruising Reddit on someone else's browser. Doesn't mark everything as read for them. I used it today because I saw a Facebook joke post about kitten wigs for sale and I knew there was a name for them I'd heard before. But I couldn't think of it. It's called a merkin. By the way, I know this because I read somewhere that a large portion of Westworld's budget went to merkins. So when I use my email on my husband's computer, it doesn't sign him out. He doesn't know his password, and apparently it's my fault if he can't sign in. I hate targeted ads so much. I'm in the closet and don't want my targeted ads or autocomplete to have any of the queer shit I look up, in case someone else is looking over my shoulder while I'm online. When I'm visiting shady ass links that might lead to porn I'm not expecting. To get around paywalls on sites that allow limited access before requiring a subscription, i.e. news sites. To prevent YouTube from overreacting to videos I want to watch once, not forever. Get around paywalls. So I can view web pages that have a soft paywall and only allow you to view one article per month. I want to look up a part on Amazon without suddenly getting bombarded with banner ads for said part. Yes. I was looking at M4 bolts. But now I'm going to use M6s. Great as for M4 bolts. Web dev. It doesn't just not keep history. It ditches cookies as well. So if you ever need to be logged into two accounts on the same site, like if you're testing user interaction, it works great. To find the meaning of an obscure Cards Against Humanity card. To log into personal accounts on another computer without having to worry about forgetting to log out. I know this is a semi-old post, but I'll answer anyway. For whatever reason, seeing my search history or leaving traces bothers me. So I've used Incognito for years now. My YouTube accounts also have their search history paused cleared so I don't have to see what my prior activity. It started as just a way to hide what I was doing, but now it makes me uncomfortable to go back to regular settings as there isn't really a reason to. Troubleshooting browser issues. Can't log into a web page? Open in Incognito. If it works. Clear cookies. Saves time on the folk that don't do regular maintenance. Looking at items from a dispensary. My dad sometimes borrows my laptop. It's not worth the hassle. Ducking like and subscribe.